What are the signs and symptoms that will indicate somebody having a low testosterone? One is a low libido, which is very common. One is erectile dysfunction. People are not able to get erection, or they get an erection, they are not able to sustain it. There's no shame in the game, because especially when you're in your 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s, your testosterone level begin to decrease.
So why is testosterone such an important thing for men? And indeed, if you are having or experiencing low testosterone, are there ways to improve your situation naturally? Today's video is going to highlight all this and more. I've got a special guest joining me on the show today. His name is Selasi Kwami. He's a family nurse practitioner who also has experience in mental health and practices internal medicine. I'll be right back. Welcome back. This is my YouTube channel and my name is Jessica. So how do you introduce or increase testosterone naturally? Joining me right now, David Kwami Selasi. David, so good to see you. How are you doing today?
I'm excellent. How are you doing yourself?
Super. I'm super. Can't complain. It's a great day. So, I mean, let's just jump right into the topic without, you know, any frills. Why is testosterone such an important thing for men?
Testosterone is a very important hormone for men because it helps with the sex drive, libido, it helps with the bone formation. And it's this whole kind of decipher a man from a woman. All the women kind of have a little bit of testosterone in their system. Men need a full testosterone level to be able to kind of like function normally. It can kind of help with the energy level. And if we do not have a full level of testosterone, it can cause depression. It causes a lot of fatigue and it causes a lot of sleep issues for a lot of men. Yeah. So you need a testosterone for bone growth, libido, sex drive, and a whole lot of things to kind of, should I say, to make you a full man.
Right. So how do men typically know if they have low testosterone? Are there certain things that happen?
Yeah, there are a few indications that come around if you have a low testosterone level. Usually men who have concerns, sometimes they come and say, I think my libido level is low. I think my energy level is low. So for you to investigate all that as an outpatient provider, first of all, you need to kind of like run a bunch of lab works. So you check for their TSH, which is the thyroid, to make sure it's not thyroid related. You check for the sugar level to make sure it's not sugar related. And you check for the testosterone level to make sure that it's not testosterone related. And sometimes when you check all those things and do complete blood work, sometimes you check all those things, you might end up finding out that, oh, okay, the testosterone level is low. Or maybe it has nothing to do with the testosterone. It has to do with the TSH, which has to do with the thyroid, because thyroid can fluctuate all that. It can make you fatigued, tired, and I feel like it causes a lot of sleep issues. And with the sugar too can cause the same issues. And there are a whole host of things that could cause that.
Is libido the only way or indicator, you know, that would let a man know that he has low testosterone? And when should he start to worry? Is it normal for testosterone levels to just dip and increase from time to time, depending on the stage of your life?
Yes, testosterone level begin to dip somewhere when you get into your 30s. Yeah, I don't want anybody to kind of get frightened. 30s, it can begin to dip by point. By 40s, it begin to dip. So as you grow older, your testosterone level begin to kind of drop a little bit on a gradual basis. It should not drop significant, but if so, at the point that it drops significantly, then you begin to have symptoms. So to answer your question, yes, as we grow as men, our testosterone level is expected to kind of like decrease gradually, but not steeply. Once it kind of decreases steeply, then we have to kind of begin to kind of investigate. Sometimes the hormonal issues or hypogonadism, which the hormonal imbalances could cause that. So
the hypo what? You're gonna have to take it slow for us. We're not in the same field as you. The hypo what?
Hypogonadism, yeah. So it's just like the imbalance of the hormone or production of the testosterone to the level that it's supposed to be. So if it's not at that level, so that is where we kind of like, we run the test, the blood test and all that to kind of identify that. And one of your questions was that, what are the signs and symptoms that will indicate somebody having a low testosterone? One is a low libido, which is very common. One is erectile dysfunction. People are not able to get erection, or they get an erection, they are not able to sustain it. Or they get an erection and it's a, we call it, they call it soft erection. They are unable to penetrate with that erection. It's erection, but it's not firm enough for them to kind of to go through penetration. And then that is a fatigue. People get fatigued and tired a lot. Yeah, and as sleep disturbances comes into severe at night, they are not able to sleep, or they're kind of restless, anxious, and it causes a lot of depression too. And depression because of the hormonal imbalance, which is because your testosterone level is low. So those are signs and symptoms. So somebody coming into your office as a primary care provider reporting that, you know what, these are the symptoms I'm having. The person doesn't have to have all the symptoms that I just listed, but the person might just have a few of those symptoms. As a primary care provider, you want to go out and find out what is going on. How do you do that? You get a good history from the patient. Get a very good history from the patient. After you get a history, you order a comprehensive lab work. You know, and usually the testosterone lab work, we kind of order it for you to do it before 8 a.m. And we tell you to kind of prevent, avoid sexual intercourse before the testosterone level. And you have to, and you have to repeat it about twice for us to confirm that it's true, your testosterone level is low.
What is the reason for, you know, the test, like doing before 8 a.m. basically, such an early
time? Because at that point, it's presumed that there's an accumulation of the testosterone level overnight, because men usually in early morning erection, that is when your testosterone level actually kind of increases, kind of boosts up in your system. So early morning will give us a better indication of where you are in your testosterone level. And if there is an issue, we will kind of go ahead and address it.
Makes sense. Makes a lot of sense. So let's get into some of the lifestyle changes that men can make to increase their testosterone level naturally. When I first chanced upon this topic, I thought, oh, wait, so are there also ways that you can increase testosterone unnaturally?
Yes.
Okay. And what are those before we get into the natural one?
We have the androgel, we have the androderm, and we have the pellets, which is an injectable that you get. But most people try to kind of avoid all that. What we kind of encourage patients to do is that we want you to kind of try all the natural way to enhance. And most people who are at the a reproductive age of their life, young men who are at a reproductive age of their life and having a low testosterone, we encourage you to do the lifestyle modification so that will help kind of boost up the testosterone level for you, because why most testosterone therapies reduces sperm count, you know. Yeah, it reduces sperm count, and you might not be able to produce sperm. So if you are at a reproductive level and you go right into a testosterone replacement therapy, guess what is going to happen? You might not be able to produce children. You might not be able to be fertile going forward. Unless the person is affecting the quality of lifestyle, or the person is up in age and is not worried about any kind of reproductive issues, then you can go ahead and kind of recommend all the testosterone replacement therapy.
Makes a lot of sense. So let's come into the natural ways to increase your testosterone. From your experience and knowledge, what are the best ways to go around this?
The best ways to go around this is one strong way is a healthy lifestyle, healthy eating, lifestyle modification. You know, those are very important. You know, I know sometimes we kind of feel like eating all kind of heavy food, fatty food, meat and all those things. You want to eat a lean meat, you know what I mean? You want to wake up every morning and go for exercise and at least walk a long period of time, you know what I mean? Drink more water, avoid alcohol. And people with polysubstance use disorder. Polysubstance just means that people who use drug addicts, people who use illegal drugs on it, you need to avoid all that, you know? And you need to kind of sleep. You need to get at least 8 hours of sleep. You know, not every sleep is sleep, you know? People can lay on the bed for 12 hours, might not be able to get any good sleep, but you need to kind of be able to kind of get a good sleep over 8 hour period at night. That kind of help kind of rejuvenate your system, rejuvenate your testosterone production. And vitamin D level, we encourage patients to kind of go out there first thing in the morning and take a walk, you know what I mean, so that they can absorb, because vitamin D is only one vitamin that is synthesized in the skin. So if you're able to kind of accumulate the morning vitamin D in your system, it also helps. But if you're not able to do that, you can pick up a supplement over the counter. So the over the counter supplement will go a long way to also help you out. You know, so those are the lifestyle modification that we encourage people to do. If you do all that, you might end up seeing good results. It doesn't happen overnight. It's a process, because you did not get to that point overnight. So it is a process to kind of
Okay, so it's obviously like a healthy lifestyle journey that men need to really like undertake or embark on.
Yeah. Lean meat instead of, you know, cooking, you can grill the meat, you know what I mean? More vegetables and more fruits in your diet, you know, and water. You need to push a lot of water. Instead of a glass of alcohol that you take three times a day, you need to kind of reduce it significantly. I encourage my patient, you know what, every other day, fine, if you something, it's a habit that you have, every other day is great, but don't splurge, don't binge on drinking.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Alcohol, yeah. Right?
Yeah, alcohol. Alcohol is a big thing.
All right, great. So, just coming back briefly before we wrap up this conversation, do we know what kinds of side effects like men could face if they decide not to rather shape up and put their lives back on track as opposed to actually going in and using medication to bring back your testosterone levels up?
One is, yeah, if you are a man of reproductive age, you might not be able to kind of produce sperm. Sperm production kind of goes away, become completely, you don't produce sperm. And it kind of causes atrophy to the testicle. Then when the testicle, you know that testosterone is produced in the testicle. So if you get on those medications at the wrong dosage or at the wrong route, or you didn't go to the specialist to kind of titrate the medication to the right dosage for you, you can end up with all those side effects. Low sperm production can affect your bone density. And sometimes it can cause gynecomastia, which is the development of breasts in some men, you know what I mean? Either way, yeah, it can cause gynecomastia. And it can cause a lot of enlarged heart, you know what I mean? If you're on the wrong route, a wrong dosage, a large amount, which is so, and the research is still out there that it causes enlarged heart. So you need to be very careful instead of you just going over the black market to get testosterone, which you can get in this day and age. There's everything that you can get out there in the black market, but you might as well want to go to the specialist because you want this to be titrated properly, you know what I mean? And you want to kind of repeat the lab work within every 3 months so that we know that your testosterone level is getting to within normal level, or is the numbers out of it. And you have to realize that when you are on a testosterone replacement therapy, your red blood cell kind of multiply. So you'd want to kind of like keep that in control. You don't want that kind of red blood cell count to be abnormal, excessively abnormal. All those things need to be in check. That's when you're on that therapy, you need to have your blood work done at least every 6 months or 3 months. And if you are in a close monitoring, it's every 3 months.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you very much for the insights there. I mean, I think it's been pretty straightforward. The message is clear, what men need to do to be better. But I'll take your final words on this. I mean, I have a lot of young men watch this channel, men between 18 and 45. I still call them young, you know. What kind of advice what kind of advice would you give to men of that age who just maybe are starting to experience certain symptoms like low libido and all these things that you mentioned? What are the better steps to take to seek some kind of solution?
You know, just to get to the point, I don't want to kind of make race an issue. Black men, specifically, and people from ethnic background like me, it's a conversation that most people do not want to have. It's a very uncomfortable conversation to talk about. Oh, I'm having erectile dysfunction, or maybe I'm not able to get a full erection, or I'm getting a soft erection, or maybe my duration is not like. It's a conversation that is extremely uncomfortable. But all those things, there are solutions out there. So I will encourage anybody who is young out there who is experiencing a low libido or a sex drive or a fatigueness, or you feel like something is not adding up, I encourage you, get yourself checked out. You know, healthy lifestyle, alcohol, excessive alcohol in your system is not good for you. Everything in moderation. And you need to kind of take a little bit of walk every day. I tell my patient every day that you need to go for at least 30 minutes of walk on a daily basis. It's really good for you. And that 30 minutes of walk, if your work permits, you can go during the morning time that you need, you can be able to kind of accumulate vitamin D from the sun, that your body could be able to synthesize that to help production of testosterone. And ginger is something good to, which is an over the counter, something that you can, you know, ginger in your food, maybe a blend of ginger every now and then, or you can use ginger in a tea. It can also kind of help kind of stimulate your testosterone production. So I encourage anybody within the age period, speak with your primary care, speak with your provider, because that is the first line of defense, the first point of contact if there is something going on. So we investigate. It might not be testosterone level. It might be that you actually need to see a mental health practitioner who is we kind of provide you a guidance, a cognitive behavior therapy, or provide you medication to kind of help get over that hump. Sometimes it's an anxiety, sometimes depression, or sometimes you actually kind of have a low testosterone that you just needed that replenishment, need that therapy to kind of get over that threshold. So I encourage people from, especially again, as I said, Black and our ethnic people to kind of speak to their PCP. This is nothing, that there's no shame in the game, because especially when you're in your 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s, your testosterone level begin to decrease.
Thank you so much. Appreciate your time, Selasi Kwami. And we're definitely going to be talking again. But, you know, for everyone watching this video, if you have questions, you know, for my guest, you can drop them in the comments below. I'm going to find a way to get him to come into my comments and answer some of your questions and give you, you know, some more details on some of the things that he highlighted in this video. So definitely, you know, watch out for that. It's going to be good. And if you like this video, don't forget to smash the like button. Subscribe to the channel if you want more of this content. We'll be bringing a lot more healthcare providers on this particular channel. So stay with me. My name is Jessica. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.